A big part of my job is being a member of this committee, which assesses student research projects and dissertations. A common issue that my colleagues and I encounter is that some student researchers tend to confuse simple random sampling with convenience sampling. So let's talk about that. Simple random sampling is a probability sampling procedure, meaning the researcher would need to guarantee equal probability. In other words, every subject in the population should stand the same chance or the same or equal probability of being chosen as the sample. Now, to be able to achieve equal probability or to achieve this randomness, probability sampling would call for some kind of procedure in order to generate this randomness. In other words, if one wants to do a random sampling procedure, one actually cannot do it just randomly. One would actually need to do it carefully and strictly in order to achieve randomness. And there are various probability or random sampling procedures like simple random, systematic random, or stratified random, etc. But what one would notice in all those procedures is that they're all strictly designed and performed so as to achieve randomness. I will link another video here in which I talked about probability versus non-probability sampling methods. On the other hand, convenience sampling is a non-probability sampling method. Simply put, in convenience sampling, the researcher would essentially do whatever is easy and efficient and convenient in order to obtain a desired sample. Although that might be a bit of an oversimplification, but that's roughly the idea. Sometimes people would confuse simple random sampling and convenience sampling. What we see sometimes is that a student researcher would say in his or her research proposal, "I'm going to walk around the mall and randomly ask people to fill out a survey, and thereby the sample is a random sample, resulting from a simple random sampling procedure." Now, the issue with that is that it is not actually a random sample, it is a convenience sample, because the procedure itself has no mechanisms to guarantee equal probability or true randomness. Think about it, if I were to walk around the mall and freely and randomly choose whoever I want to ask and ask them to fill out a survey, subconsciously, it is very likely that I would be drawn to those people and ask those people who appear to be more approachable, cooperative, and friendly. We all have unconscious biases, which means if we are to rely only on our intuition and free will when choosing a sample, the resulting sample most likely would not be a 100% accurate representation of the population. And that is why we should not confuse simple random sampling with convenience sampling. One is a probability sampling procedure and the other is not. Taking this example a little bit further, how can we turn this convenience sampling procedure into something that's more probability-based? What one can do is, for instance, instead of just walking around the mall and asking people, one can actually pick a fixed position, choose a random passerby to fill out the survey, and then let, say, 30 passersby pass and pick another person, then let another 30 pass, pick another. So, skip, pick. Skip, pick, using a predetermined skip interval. This procedure would be something that more resembles a probability sampling procedure as it does counter the unconscious bias which might exist in convenience sampling through the use of a fixed, predetermined skip interval instead of only relying on the researcher's personal instincts and preferences. But now some would say, just because I use this skip interval and pick a person based on this procedure, that doesn't mean I get a truly probability-based representative sample, because the person whom I do pick can still decline to participate in the study, or that person might fill out the survey improperly, resulting in the survey being unusable. So I would still have a sampling error. Now that is true, and that's a good point we should keep in mind. The fact is, we would always have sampling errors to varying degrees, because the sample is simply not the population. But the point of using a random or probability sampling procedure is that, when properly designed and performed, the resulting sample from a probability sampling procedure would be a closer representation of the population. We still don't get 100% representativeness and 100% absolute equal probability, but we get closer to it. And that is the point. All right, that's it for this brief video. Thanks for watching this Ranywayz Random video. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.